for women who want to do elective egg freezing, the big thing is, the thing that I want to concentrate on, the cancer patient has no choice. It could be 10, 20, or 30% chance that these eggs will get her pregnant somewhere, someday. But she has no choice because in a week or a month, she's going to get chemotherapy or radiation, and she's not going to have a choice anymore. The 32-year-old who hasn't found Mr. Right still has a choice to freeze embryos or to date and postpone her fertility, that it's not as urgent. If she was 32, maybe she'll wait till she's 33 or 35. There isn't an urgency.
So egg freezing became important because women's reproductive potential is limited by their age. So women are born with the number of eggs that they will ever have in their entire lives. There has been some research to suggest that perhaps oocytes regenerate, but nothing has come onto the clinical scene to convince us that, quite honestly, once you hit about 40, 42, 45, those years of being able to spontaneously conceive and have a baby have really passed by, the so-called biological clock. There is a cohort of eggs recruited each month, and only one of those eggs will actually make it to maturity, ovulate, and potentially be fertilized for conception. The goal in egg freezing is to capture one of those cohorts so that those eggs are stimulated from a very immature stage with medications, and these medications are injectable gonadotropins. Gonadotropins are the hormones that are produced by the brain that stimulate the ovaries to make eggs. So in injectable form, we can give these to patients, healthy women, who will then go on to make many eggs in one cycle, and this takes about 2 weeks until they're ready for their eggs to be retrieved. During this process, while the medications are being injected, the patient is undergoing monitoring to ensure that the follicles where the eggs are growing actually increase in size and that the patient is responding by increasing her estrogen levels. These are the two markers we use in order for us to know, we doctors, to know that the patient is responding to the medication. Much like a typical IVF cycle, then, the patient undergoes an egg retrieval, and once the eggs are removed by a transvaginal ultrasound-guided aspiration procedure, those eggs that are mature are frozen for later use.
But the honesty and the counseling, when you don't have a medical reason to do it, in my opinion, is even more crucial, in that you need to go through the fact that you could pay thousands of dollars to freeze your eggs and you never use them because next year you're going to meet Mr. Right. What it cost, the injections, the complications, the risks, and also a false sense that this insurance policy guarantees something. In other words, if a young woman freezes 10 eggs in an IVF laboratory, she doesn't have 10 children in the freezer. She's got 10 eggs. And that's maybe, depending on the skill of the laboratory she's going at, a chance, a 40% chance for one or two children. She may never use those eggs. She could use them and still never get a child. And she still has choices to arrange her social life so that maybe she doesn't need to do this at all. And I wouldn't want a 32-year-old woman coming to me for this to have a false sense of security. Well, then I can stay at my law firm until 1 o'clock in the morning every night for 5 years because I've got these eggs in the freezer and I'm guaranteed a family. They're not. And so if it's just an insurance policy, but you're gonna still keep dating and you're gonna make your social life as important as your career, then that's a reasonable choice. But if you think that you have a guarantee of a family by freezing your eggs, that's false hope and misleading, and that I would hate to see women not making other important life decisions because they thought they were in the clear because they've got eggs in the freezer. And again, they, just like the cancer patients, I'm saying you need to go to a place with experience. Now, ask the IVF program where you're going to. Do you freeze eggs? Yes. And how often do you do this? And have you ever thawed eggs and gotten anyone pregnant? But it becomes even more important when you're using technology in an elective social sense and not a medical necessity sense. But it is there, and I hope my daughter, who's a lawyer, dates and gets pregnant the old-fashioned way, but I bet my granddaughters are going to all be freezing their eggs. If you have very personal questions about your own specific fertility issues, I please encourage you to make an appointment with one of the physicians who will review your history in detail and give you the most honest, up-to-date information for your particular fertility issues. And you should be excited. People seeing infertility doctors shouldn't be depressed about it, because everything that you've seen here today is, there's almost no one that we can't help in some way. And that's the exciting thing for this generation and generations to come compared to, say, previous generations. So don't be afraid to talk to someone about these issues. Thank you.